Good evening. The time is 9 p.m. U.S. Central Time. This program is coming to you live from Chicago. And in the news at this hour, Democrats and several state leaders are pushing back on what they see as the Trump administration's attempt to undermine the U.S. Postal Service in order to influence the upcoming presidential election. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi is calling on the House to return to Washington for an unheard-of session during presidential convention season to address the concerns. Democrats also want the new Postmaster General to testify and address charges that his new policy changes are intended to deliberately slow mail-in voting. At the behest of the new Postmaster General, the USPS has slowed delivery, removed high-speed letter sorters, and will no longer give automatic priority to mail-in ballots. At least half a dozen states, including Colorado, North Carolina, and Virginia, are considering legal action to stop the changes from going into effect. New Jersey Democratic House member Bill Pascrell Jr. made a criminal referral last Friday to the New Jersey Attorney General, seeking the impaneling of a state grand jury to look at possible charges against President Trump, Postmaster General Louis DeJoy, and other officials. In the matter of in-person voting, Dr. Anthony Fauci advises that as long as people observe the usual cautions of masking and social distancing, there should be no problems.
I think if carefully done according to the guidelines, there's no reason that I can see why that not be the case. For example, you know, when you look at going to a grocery store now, they have X's every 6 or more feet. And it says, don't leave this spot until the person in front of you left their spot. And you can do that. If you go and wear a mask, if you observe the physical distancing and don't have a crowded situation, there's no reason why we shouldn't be able to vote in person or otherwise.
Dr. Anthony Fauci. The Democratic National Convention kicked off today. The completely virtual event will play out among four stages in New York City, Los Angeles, Milwaukee, and Wilmington, Delaware. And it will culminate with the formal nomination of former Vice President Joe Biden and his running mate, California U.S. Senator Kamala Harris. The DNC plans to air only 2 hours of primetime programming per day, and experts say this sort of scaled-down version could affect how future conventions are held. The New York Times, meanwhile, reports a cluster of new national opinion polls, all showing Biden maintaining a significant lead over Donald Trump, leaving Biden in a stronger position to oust an incumbent president than any challenger heading into his party's convention in the modern polling era. On average, Mr. Biden leads by 8 to 9 percentage points among likely voters, the largest and most consistent polling lead that any candidate has held since Bill Clinton maintained a double-digit advantage over incumbent George H. Bush in 1996. According to the Washington Post, Republican and Democratic leaders of the Senate Intelligence Committee told the Justice Department last July they believed several people close to President Trump, including his son Donald Trump Jr., son-in-law Jared Kushner, and former advisor Steve Bannon, may have lied during congressional testimony. It is not yet clear whether their suspicions led to any further inquiries or ongoing investigations. This news comes after Senate Committee Chairman announced this month they had adopted a fifth and final report, yet to be released to the public, dealing with Russian interference in 2016. Here is our nightly coronavirus update, an additional word from Dr. Anthony Fauci. He warns that young people who contract the virus are in danger of serious and lasting damage, more so than was previously believed, even after ostensibly recovering. Fauci said checkups afterward are showing that many have substantially high proportions of cardiovascular abnormalities, including inflammation of the heart muscle, and other heart ailments. Here are the latest numbers from the U.S. Center for Disease Control. Total cases now in the U.S., 5,400,000. That is up from yesterday's figure by 42,000. Estimated death toll now stands at 170,000. That is up by 650 from yesterday's estimate. More news in a moment. Now this.
CDC is working to help keep you and your community safe from the threat of a novel or new coronavirus. There are steps you can take now to get ready if an outbreak occurs in your community. Make a household plan. Learn how to prepare and to take quick action if someone gets sick. Older adults and people with chronic medical conditions are at greater risk. Take extra steps to protect them. Think about what you will do if there are changes to your work schedule. And remember to always practice good health habits, such as frequently washing hands with soap and water, staying home when sick, and covering coughs and sneezes. For more information, visit cdc.gov.
9:06 p.m. in other news. In economic news, Japan has suffered its biggest economic slump on record. The world's third largest economy saw its gross domestic product fall by 7.8% in the most recent quarter, which translates to approximately a 28% decline on an annualized basis. The U.S. economy fared even worse than that, with an annualized drop of 33% last quarter. A mixture on Wall Street today, Dow Jones Industrial Average down by 86 points to close at 27,845. NASDAQ up 110 at 11,130. And the S&P 500 up slightly to 3,382. That's plus 9 points. And here's the weather report. A major heat wave will continue across the western U.S. much of this week with dangerously hot temperatures, 120 degrees or more in the desert southwest, and the usual accompanying fire alerts. Relatively cool conditions, on the other hand, will prevail from the plains eastward, with occasional showers and storms from the Mississippi Valley to the Atlantic coast. For Chicagoland, clear skies ahead. So far, no mention of rain until at least Friday. Tonight, partly cloudy, low around 66. Tomorrow, Tuesday, mostly sunny but cooler, high in the mid-70s. And tomorrow night, mostly clear, low 62. Our current conditions, a few clouds, 77 degrees at Midway Airport, 76 at the lakefront, relative humidity 42%, east winds at 7 miles per hour. AccuWeather radar shows some rain showers in the center of the state around Peoria and Bloomington, but in Chicagoland, all clear. The time is 9:08 p.m., and once again, here at Radio City, we have 76 delightful degrees.
Live from Chicago, Variety Broadcast presents Radio Classics. Now, here's your host, Tom Edwards.
Cherry ice cream smile.
And there we have Duran Duran, Rio, starting us off on this lovely Monday night in the Windy City of Chicago, 13 minutes after 9 o'clock, 9:13 U.S. Central Time. Sherry, our friend on the chat board, one of several friends on the chat board, was just mentioning that the Cubs are playing the Cardinals. We're a little out of my pay grade now. I can do a creditable news report and a decent weather report, but sports, I'm out of my league, pun intended. But I can read it to you off of the Google page here. It says Chicago Cubs 13-7. I have no idea what the 13-7 means, but at the present time, in the top of the sixth, it's Chicago Cubs 5, St. Louis Cardinals 4. It might be. It could be. It is a home run. You remember when old Harry Carey was a St. Louisan way back in the 1960s. He sort of found his niche, though, once he got up here to Chicago. Boy, they loved him, just loved him. And most of them up here don't even know that he's dead, to tell you the truth. They've got a restaurant of his downtown on Dearborn, corner of Dearborn and Hubbard, and a big bronze statue of him outside the ballpark. I live just a few blocks from Wrigley Field, so I walk past it now and then. And that statue of Harry Carey, he's standing holding a microphone as he used to do, pointing it at the crowds so they could sing Take Me Out to the Ball Game, you know. Now, I really don't follow it. I couldn't tell you the difference between a home run and a hand of gin rummy. I really don't know sports. But I must say, now when they won the World Series couple of years ago, that was exciting. It was really nice. It was fun to see the whole town get behind them and be so enthusiastic and all. And I had my windows open that night, and I remember, you remember there was a slight rain delay, and then they resumed the game, and then that's when the Cubs pulled it off and they won. It was like New Year's Eve and then some. I mean, all of Wrigleyville just erupted in wild, mad cheers that night. Is that 2 years ago? I've kind of lost track. Well, anyway, speaking of keeping track of time, today is Monday the 17th of August. It is Discovery Day, according to our friends at nationaltoday.com. Now, Discovery Day happens to be an annual event in Yukon, Canada. I suppose we could celebrate it here by going out and getting a new Discover card. It is also National Black Cat Appreciation Day. I had a little black cat for 18 and a half years. We named him Black Sambuca, and we called him Sam for short. Oh, do I miss him. What a character he was. Now, no offense to my little buddy, Mr. J. Cat Rockefeller. I love him, too. Rocky is in the other room taking a nap, I think, at the moment, so he's left me to my own devices, but I'm sure he will sooner or later be popping in to say hello. Scott mentions that his mother and Harry Carey's wife were friends. I do remember that. Yes, Dutchie Carey is right. Was that a nickname, or was it probably, huh? Or was that her real name? I don't know. Well, let's see now. Speaking of friends on the chat board, now that reminds me, we play trivia, our big claim to fame, our world-famous trivia game. And if you would like to play along with us, we welcome you to join. All you have to do is sign in with your Google account. Google and YouTube are connected. And if you sign in with your regular Google account, like if you have Gmail or Google Payments or any of those products, just sign in with your regular name and password, and it will hook you right up to our chat board. Then you can talk to the other members of the audience and play our trivia game. I have a couple of friends who have contacted me backstage, you might say, by way of Facebook or other contact mechanisms, and they've told me that they are having trouble locating the chat board on their cell phones, and well, we understand. Maybe if I was going to say if you could let the other participants on the board know, but that's not possible if you can't type to them, is it? Well, anyway, use a laptop. Maybe you can join us that way. I think it varies from one cell phone to the next, depending on what brand you have, what model you have, because I've tried making screen captures on my cell phone and drawing arrows and circles and whatnot, and then they say to me, well, I don't see that on my cell phone. See, cell phones are just not my specialty. I can take a computer apart and put it back together again, but I'm afraid with cell phones, I'm just kind of out of my league. It's like sports. Okay. But at any rate, we will get the trivia game started. If you can find a way to sign in, why, we would love to have you. But if not, just sit in the background and relax. We're glad to have you here one way or another. And the game will start in just a moment.
Mabel, Black Label, Carling's Black Label Beer.
In a swanky club or the corner pub,
at bars from border to border,
the beer they name is always the same.
Is how they order.
In a big chateau or a bungalow,
wherever there's a table,
that favorite beer always rates a cheer
and a whistle for Black Label. Mabel, Black Label, Carling's Black Label Beer.
Wherever you go, you're likely to hear that familiar whistle for Carling's Black Label. Today, this celebrated premium brew is America's fastest growing beer. There's a reason, of course. Black Label's premium quality is yours to enjoy at the popular price.
Carling's Black Label, Carling's Black Label Beer. It's a premium brew at the popular price. Enjoy the best, take our advice. Get Carling's Black Label, Carling's Black Label Beer.
Mabel, Black Label. Now that one brings back way old memories. I remember those commercials on the TV when I was just a little bitty kid. Those are some of my very earliest memories. Anyway, now, before we get to the trivia game, let's take a vote on something. I'll let you decide whether you want to continue enforcing the strict spelling rules or whether you want to ease up on that. In other words, do we want to continue insisting upon proper spelling for proper nouns and that sort of thing, or should we just ease up and say that any answer that is, you know, legible, readable, whatever, is okay? This is how you should vote. If you want to keep the rules as they are, just type the word keep on your screen, okay? Type the word keep if you want to keep the rules as they are. If you want to go easier on spelling, in other words, if you want to be less strict about spelling, if somebody, you know, misspells like, Carling Black Label Beer, if they spell it with a K instead of a C, you still know what they meant, so we should accept that answer. If you want to ease up on spelling, type easy, E-A-S-Y. So that's how you vote. Keep if you want to keep the rules as they are. On the other hand, type easy if you want to ease up on the spelling. And I'll give you some time to do that. We'll play a piece of music, and then we'll come back and start the trivia game. Okay, so you vote now, and we'll tally things up and see how it goes. Up next, Billy Joel musically for us, Uptown Girl on Radio Classics.
She's looking for a downtown man. That's what I am.
And there we have the music of Mr. Billy Joel for you, 924 on Radio Classics. And here's how we play trivia. We play for Monopoly money, and whoever has the most Monopoly dollars saved up by the end of the program wins a terrific grand prize. Tonight, we are giving away the first of the prime, prestigious purple properties, St. Charles Place. It's right next to the jail, but the prisoners don't generally cause too many problems. There's one old, loud, drunk fella named Otis who comes in late singing and hollering, but that's only on Friday nights. He's harmless otherwise. Now, remember, please, no search engines, no Google, no Bing, no Yahoo. Draw from your own knowledge. It's much more fun. Now, spelling, we have a vote in progress. We are voting on this. If we want to keep our current spelling rules, type on your chat board screen, keep. But if you want to ease up so that we don't focus on spelling errors, in other words, if anything is readable, as long as it's, you know, phonetically in the ballpark, we'll accept it as an answer, then type easy. In other words, ease up on spelling. Okay, and then lastly, be careful about multi-part questions. We do those from time to time, so please answer all parts of the question to make sure your answer is counted. And let's see. We have 1, 2, 3 on ease up. Sherry hasn't voted yet, but and I'm not sure what a quorum is, but we'll let that go for another minute or two and let everybody decide. But meantime, we'll fly our first trivia question up the flagpole. Here we go. And this one is $20. Now, we're still under the current spelling rules until such time as that is lifted. So please spell carefully, because this one will involve a proper noun, as it is a title of a television show. All right, here are your clues. $20 TV trivia. James Buchanan High School and the Sweat Hogs. John Travolta's big show business break. Name the show. All right, $20 on the barrel. James Buchanan High School and the Sweat Hogs. And John Travolta's big show business break. Tell me the name of that show. And good luck.
I like girls. Watch you.
The incomparable Elton John, island girl. She has, yes, an island car with which she drives all around Palm Beach County. I remember. 9:31, 29 minutes before 10 o'clock. Let's see now. We had one entry by text message. Gwen seems to be locked out on the chat board. I really don't know what the problem could possibly be, why some of our contestants are able to jump right on and others aren't. And Gwen is not the only one. My friend Celeste also said there is something wrong, something is blocking her. When you jump on to the YouTube page that shows, you know, my emblem at the top and then other menu items down at the bottom, there's supposed to be a button there that you can tap on or click on that says chat. And they say the button is not there for them. And that is just baffling to me. I can't even conjecture. I can't even hazard a guess. It is on my cell phone. I don't know if any of the other folks who are able to type can maybe give some pointers on this. Anything to help untangle it would be of interest. So let us know if you have any tips to share. Now, meantime, congrats to Scott, who hit the first question of the night. Good job. A $20 TV trivia question spelled beautifully and correctly. The TV show is indeed Welcome Back, Cotter.
Give it a smack, Bonomo. Give it a crack, Bonomo. Then lift up the flap, strip off the wrap, and hey, away we go. We're gonna taste Turkish taffy. Hey, it's delish. Taste Turkish taffy answers every wish.
One nice and chewy.
Two nice and sweet.
Three in the flavor that you prefer. It truly can't be beat. Cause you get chocolate vanilla.
Strawberry too. Even banana doodle-oodle-oo.
When you take a trip to your candy store, be sure to get you some Turkish taffy. Yum, yum, yum. You spell it B-O-N-O-M-O. Bonomo. Oh-oh. Bonomo.
Hey, one more time.
You spell it B-O-N-O-M-O. Bonomo. Oh-oh. Bonomo. Turkish taffy.
And that ain't all. All right, let's open up the dictionary, shall we?
Word of the day.
Indeed, the word of the day is malaise. M-A-L-A-I-S-E. Now, the preferred pronunciation is malaise, but according to Merriam-Webster, the good dictionary people, it can also be pronounced malaise. The definition is an indefinite feeling of debility or lack of health, often indicative of or accompanying the onset of an illness. Second definition, a vague sense of mental or moral ill-being. Use it in a sentence, as my seventh grade teacher was fond of saying. All right. U.S. President Jimmy Carter made a televised speech in July of 1979, and although he never actually used the word in his address, it became known as the malaise speech anyway. He referred to a national malaise a few days later, and that's the name that stuck. And yes, I realize I just made two sentences, but who's counting? There we have it. The word of the day from Merriam-Webster, the dictionary people at m-w.com.
From San Francisco comes...
Rice-a-roni, the San Francisco treat. Rice-a-roni, the flavor can't be beat.
One pan, no boiling, cooking ease.
A flavor that is sure to please.
Rice-a-roni, the San Francisco treat.
Rice-a-roni, the delicious break from potatoes, now in six fabulous flavors.
One pan, no boiling, cooking ease.
A flavor that is sure to please.
Rice-a-roni, the San Francisco treat.
All right, trivia, round two. Here we go. $25. Our category is movies. The year is 2003, and I'm seated in the theater, my usual favorite seat, about a dozen rows back, aisle seat. I have my tub of butter popcorn, my extra, extra large pig out-sized bag of strawberry Twizzlers, and, of course, a medium Sprite to wash it down with. All right, the comics and the coming attractions have finished, and the feature presentation starts to roll. All right, the credits include Jim Carrey, Morgan Freeman, Jennifer Aniston, Philip Baker Hall, and directed by Tom Shadyac. All right, want a hint? Heavenly. Tell me the name of the movie. All right, $25. Movies came out in 2003, starring Jim Carrey, Morgan Freeman, Jennifer Aniston, Philip Baker Hall, directed by Tom Shadyac, and we'll give you the additional hint, Heavenly. Tell me the name of the film for 25 Monopoly dollars. There we have Barbara Harris, who was the lead singer of The Toys. Their original hit was 1965. How Gentle Is the Rain? It's called A Lover's Concerto, and that is actually Barbara doing it at a 2012 live concert. You still got it, baby. That was absolutely terrific. All right, Maestro, could we have our nice dramatic opening music as we look back on this date in history for the 17th of August. On this date in 1978, the Double Eagle 2 completes the first transatlantic balloon flight when it landed in a barley field near Paris, 137 hours after lifting off from Presque Isle, Maine. The helium-filled balloon was piloted by Ben Abruzzo, Maxie Anderson, and Larry Newman. They flew 3,233 miles in their six-day odyssey. Somebody ought to make a film out of that. 1877 on this date, Billy the Kid shot his first man. Though only a teenager at the time, Billy wounded an Arizona blacksmith who died the following day. He was the famous outlaw's first victim. Just how many men Billy killed is uncertain. Billy himself reportedly once claimed he had killed 21 men, one for every year of my life. All right, grisly, huh? 1962 on this date, the East Germans killed a man trying to cross the Berlin Wall. They gunned down a young fellow who was trying to escape across the wall from East into West Berlin, and they left him on the pavement to bleed to death. One of the worst, ugliest incidents to take place during the Cold War. 1969, something happier. The grooviest event in music history. The Woodstock Music and Art Fair drew to a close after 3 days of peace, love, and rock and roll in upstate New York. This was the day, the final day, they shut it down. Famous birthdays today. American frontiersman Davy Crockett, born 1786. Samuel Goldwyn, movie mogul and producer, the G in MGM, born 1882. Comedic actress Mae West, I'm as pure as the snow, then I drifted, born 1893. The late actress Maureen O'Hara, born 1921. Actor Robert De Niro is celebrating number 77 today. And actor Sean Penn, number 60.
Escape! Come on over to Royal Crown Cola. It's a mad, 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 mad cola. RC, the one with the mad, mad taste. Better shake. Check the one that's really mad. It's a mad, 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 mad cola. RC, the one with the mad, mad taste. RC.
All right, our $25 movie category, movie trivia question is on the table, and I believe we had a winner on that, didn't we? Yes, indeed. Scott was the fastest fingers on that one, so audience, round of applause. $25 goes on to Scott's score. Bruce Almighty is the name of the film. That was a good one. Jim Carrey, Morgan Freeman, and the rest, directed by Tom Shadyac. Yes, indeed, Bruce Almighty. Well, now let's see. Our voting about easing up on trivia spelling, we are tied. We have three votes on the board for yes. Scott voted ease up. Charlotte, ease up. Mike, ease up. And then Sherry, Susan, and by text message, Gwen, all voted to keep the rules as they are. Do I have to break the tie? Does Rocky get to break the tie? Oh, decisions, decisions. Meantime, another question. Here we go. Oh, goody. Name that tune. Goody, goody, goody. My favorite. All right. I can give you a couple of hints on this one. It is a top 20 hit in 1977 for a group. Now, please remember, it is a two-part question. Like all of our Name That Tunes, we need both singer and song. So please make sure you answer both parts of the question in order to have your entry counted. All right, $25 for the first correct answer on the chat board. Turn up your volume just a little bit. Here comes your audio clue.
Name That Tune.
And now, here's more of Radio Classics with your host, Tom Edwards.
Well, I decided we needed to overdose on sugar. There we go. Bo Donaldson and the Haywoods, Billy, Don't Be a Hero. I remember the summer that that came out. I was in high school, and our family had a membership at the nearby country club with a swimming pool, and they had a loudspeaker system over which they could make announcements, of course, and also they would play the radio. And I remember that song came on the radio, and all the little kids around the pool were all singing Billy, Don't Be a Hero. It was like a scene out of the Brady Bunch or the Partridge Family or something. Like I say, just overdosed, covered in sugar. All right, now let's see. Where do we stand on the trivia game? We have Name That Tune in progress. Now, we have a couple of correct guesses about the group, but nobody has come up with the name of the tune yet, so we'll play the audio clue for you one more time and then take a quick commercial break and see if anybody can come up with it in that amount of time. Here we go. Here's your audio clue once more.
A sound that flows into my mind.
The echoes of the daylight.
Of everything that is alive.
All right, and we do have correct answers on the group, but we are looking for the title of the song. You got 60 seconds.
What do you want when you gotta eat something? And it's gotta be sweet, and it's gotta be a lot, and you gotta have it now. What do you want?
Mix, mac, and
paddywhacking, inkin' knackin', zilkalackin', scalawackin', crackerjackin', boo, crackerjack. What do you get when you open the top and look inside and smack your lip and turn it over and fill it out? What do you get? Lip smacking, whip cracking, fatty whacking, all of your zacking, finko lacking, alligator acting, cracker jacking, cracker jack. Candy coated popcorn, peanuts and a prize. That's what you get in Cracker Jack.
All right, time's up. Nobody got it. Several correct answers on the name of the group. The Electric Light Orchestra, also called ELO. Yes, that is absolutely right. But nobody came up with the right answer for the name of the song. It is called Turn to Stone. All right, let's have another question then. Back to the drawing board. Here we go. Sweets and treats this time, $20. This candy was originally called M&M's Fruit Chewies, but they changed the name in the late 1960s. Today there is a variation you can buy with tropical flavors, but the original flavors, which are still on the market, include strawberry, lemon, orange, and cherry. Name the candy. All right, this candy was originally called M&M's Fruit Chewies, but they changed the name in the late 1960s. There is a variation you can buy with tropical flavors, but the originals, which are still on the market, include strawberry, lemon, orange, and cherry. Name the candy. Meantime, here's the Name That Tune that nobody got. Electric Light Orchestra, Turn to Stone.
The city streets are empty now.
The lights don't shine no more.
Turn the stone when you're coming home. I can't go on.
The Electric Light Orchestra, the name that tune that nobody got. And it happens to be one of my favorites. Turn to Stone from the mid-1970s. Love that one. All right, 9:56. We're in the home stretch. 4 minutes till 10 o'clock. And the winner of the last round of trivia by cell phone text message, that would be Gwen. She's locked out of the chat board for some reason due to the vagaries of YouTube tonight, but she did get the first answer correct. The sweets and treats category, the candy we were looking for, Starburst. Good job.
Do you know exactly how to eat an Oreo? Well, to do it, you unscrew it very fast. Cause a kid'll eat the middle of an Oreo first and save the chocolate cookie outside for last.
See? There's so much frosty cream between.
Aren't Oreo kids lucky? Aren't Oreo mothers wonderful?
Cause a kid'll eat the middle of an Oreo first and save the chocolate cookie outside for last.
All right, now we have to break that tie on the voting, don't we? Unless, now somebody called my attention to it. I did not see any tie-breaking vote come by on the chat screen. So if I'm correct, I have to break the tie. We will flip a coin. All right, Rocky has lent me a quarter. Now let's make sure it doesn't drop on the floor because I need these for my laundry. All right, here we go. Heads, we will keep things as they are, as far as the spelling, and tails, we will ease up, and we will take any answer as long as it's reasonably in the ballpark, you know, as long as you can make out phonetically what it says. All right, so to put that in briefer fashion, heads, we keep, tails, we ease up on spelling. Here we go. It's on the floor. Wait a minute. And it is tails. We ease up on spelling. Oh, gee, that was fun. All right, Maestro, could we have the theme song, please? And we'll settle up the trivia game. All right, our scoreboard, final scoreboard looks like this. Gwen, $20, second place. And Scott came in with $45 and takes the purple property, St. Charles Place. All right, good job. A nice round of all for all of our contestants. Good job. Y'all done good. And grand prize winner of the night, Scott, wins St. Charles Place. Hoorah! Okay. Well, it was fun. Thanks a lot for tuning in. And I'll go back to the drawing board and see if I can come up with anything on why some of our friends have been locked out of the chat board. I have no idea, but maybe there's a help screen on YouTube that might help me decode that. I'll work on it. Okay. In the meantime, be sure to keep your mask on whenever you go out for an errand. Listen to the medical experts. Don't listen to the crazy man in the Oval Office. And if you would pass the word along to a friend or two about the broadcast, I'd appreciate that. Let them know we are here Monday through Friday, starting at 10 Eastern Time, 9 Central, 8 Mountain, 7 Pacific, brought to you by Nabisco. Just tell them to use whatever internet device they're using and punch up TomEdwards.info. Got that? TomEdwards.info. And that should work just like call forwarding on a telephone, and it'll take them right to the YouTube page. All right. I'll talk to you tomorrow night. Thanks again for tuning in. All the best to you.